Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, we will start creating our first multi-object pick and place applications. Let's get started. For this video, we will open our training folder once again, and this time take the 03D organize box station. If you bring it here, you will see that we have a table, we have an array or a tray with boxes on top of it. We have a robot with no tool, and we have a bunch of blocks, all called block. So the first thing we need to do is to create our tool, obviously. So if you open the folder once again, you have your epicktool.sld source solid RoboDK object. So I can simply drag and drop that to RoboDK. By default, it will be imported at the root of the station or the origin of the station. I can uncollapse the reference frame of the robot or robot reference frame, and I can drag and drop the tool on the UR5E here. So by doing so, it created automatically a tool called epic, and it added it directly to the robot reference or the robot flange. As you can see, it's not necessarily in the right position, so that was obviously on purpose in this case. It's a reminder of how you can move the tool geometry with respect to the robot flange. If you double click on it, you can go for more options. For now, as you can see, we need to rotate here, so this section here should point towards the z-axis. So to do that, I'm pretty sure you will agree that we need to rotate around the x-axis, so we need to rotate like that. So as usual, you can either just come here and say, okay, rotation around x, y, z. So x, y, z, use your scroll wheel and then just figure out the right value. But if you remember, or if you know, like counterclockwise motions are positive motion and clockwise motions are negative motions in terms of degrees. So if I want to rotate here 1/4 of a turn in this direction, I need to do a positive rotation of 90 degrees. So let's do that like this here. That brings my tool in the right direction. I will go and click apply move in this case. And then I would like maybe to have the RoboTK logo right in front of myself. So I will rotate here another 90 degrees here. So apply move, perfect. That was the first thing. Now I need to set up the TCP position for this tool. So I can either just come here and then double click the tool and then figure out approximately what is the position of it. Or as I already showed you, I can go to program and then teach target on surface and select add tool here. If I add tool and select snap on arc center, I can pick one of the arc center here. I would generally not put the TCP right at the edge here, especially for a suction cup where it kind of squish in a bit or compress a bit. So like the TCP here would make sense. So I have here, by clicking here, it gives me a new tool snap. What I can do is open the tool snap here by double clicking on it. I can select copy here to copy this values here. In fact, I only really need 129.599, but I can click copy here and then I can click paste here. So both the epic and tool snap TCP are at the exact same position. So now I can get rid of the tool snap. I can activate the reference, the tool here, and I can hide the robot flange here. So right click tool flange, oops, not tool frame. I want to right click and robot flange here like that. I can close this here. So now we have our tool. So that's great. Next thing I need to do is simply I'm going to change the home position. So I already showed you that. So let's go for a small refresher. If I decide to have, I don't know, the tool, the home position should be something like that. So minus 90 here. That would make sense as a home position. So I can copy that value here, click parameters, and then set home right here. And then I can paste these values here. So this is something you won't have access if you just have the free version from our website. But apart from that, it's not a big deal. You could just create a home position here with a join target, and instead of right clicking and then go home, move home, you could simply trigger that home position or join home position. Okay, so now let's talk about what we have here in our station. So we have our six cubes and we have the three holes in which they should be placed. We also have a frame here called part. So all the targets that we will create will be with respect to that part reference frame here. So we'll have to create targets everywhere here. So, okay, and if you remember correctly, if we just bring back the organized box station here, which is the final stage or the end product, our goal is to pick the objects from here to here. So in the next video, our goal will be to create the targets to go from one position to the other. So that's the main goal of our next video. I could obviously just like kind of move the robot around and eyeball it, but that wouldn't be a very good idea, because like positioning those properly or accurately in the holes there, if you just eyeball your target position, this won't be easy. So instead I have a more accurate way of figuring out where a position is to show you in the next video. So I hope it helped, and hope to see you in the next one. Have a great day, guys.